And this time around, they're going with Shen.
Shen, you would assume, up towards the top side of the map, going to be played into the Camille, often considered a bit of a counter.
Now make his way towards the top side of the map, but no camps to take.
You can also see priority in the bot, but a skirmishing going on.
Vivid very, very low, might be taken down here. EDG looking to find that early aggro. They've got it for first blood.
And this is the duo that we were talking about
not
in the...
quite yet. Summoner spell was still down there in the mid lane in the form of that barrier as Mako goes in for the engage onto Vivid. There's no way to get out of this when it's another free kill going over the way of EDG in the bottom side of the map. Evie looking to make the dive topside onto Ray is going to be potentially outplayed as Ray nearly finds the kill and forces him to flash back out.
Action happens across the board as iBoy and Mako find another 2v2 kill. Clearlab now coming bot to try and secure some extra early leads.
Oh, they are snowballing this bottom lane completely out of control, Vettius. It's Clearlove setting up that kill there, making sure he grabs.
Now, as Steel makes another appearance here into the top side,
Ray's trying to hold on, get himself out of this one, drops the Spirit Refuge as the Hextech ultimatum is issued. Makes his way back underneath the turret, but is it going to be enough? Steel's taken very low. One more turret shot will bring him down.
He's
completely taken over this bottom part of the map. Vivid and Utapon trying to fight back in the 2v2, recognizing their opponents are caught between two turrets. There's no way to just walk out on this one, but iBoy's got no intention of getting himself out. There's the Stand United I'm talking about. It's never a fair fight with Shen, and that fair fight is a long dream away as Vivid now heads for the hills and runs as fast as his little legs are going to take him. But I don't think that Thresh wants to head back into bottom lane anytime soon. iBoy making sure that he supplies
power up in the top lane, and EDG will do what they can to wait for it.
Clearlove not finding a lot with that explosive cast, but EDG now still looking to go in, maybe find some sort of a fight here. Mako goes in, drops down that ultimate, continuing to chase after the Heimerdinger. Scout's not able to find the ulti of his own, still looking to go in even further. Hextech ultimatum down to Scout. DFM still looking to fight back. They may take down Scout, but they've already lost their own mid laner, and they're running for their lives. iBoy's able to find the Void Seeker. It's still going to be a 2-for-1 fight going the way of EDG as they'll chase Vivid to the wrong side of the map. He's still looking to get away somewhere, but Clearlove's got the barrel. He'll walk into the brush. Vivid, I don't think you're getting out of this one, buddy.
Vivid, unfortunately, lamb to the slaughter as he's doing what he can.
Play around as the tier 1 turret will now be beset by Shelly as bottom side detonation focus me. Look to make the 2v1 happen here yet again. Ray nowhere near a turret. Gonna be hard pressed to get
this during the group stages, but unfortunately the game unfolded as we see another fight up top.
Scout's going straight in for the dive here. Stand United means he's gonna have backup here in just a moment. Ray goes in for the taunt, can't quite find it, but he's still got the damage to go on a rampage and take the turret down as well.
That is setting up a bit of deep vision. In fact, maybe even play towards the bot side because you can see already they have a huge minion wave, a lot of deep wards covering that area of the map.
And just get that much more move speed, that much more ability to roam around between these lanes, throw down wards, set up traps, and make it, especially for two teams that have had the weaknesses historically that these two have. Ray now finding himself in that Hextech ultimatum yet again. Subjugate going to be used to shred those resistances. Killer comes out. Evie looking to go even further here, but Mako showed up to make it a fair fight. Drops the ulti down onto Evie, who's now going to find himself left alone and hung out to dry as the shutdown comes through.
Bot lane, and because of all the vision that EDG have controlled towards the bot side of the map, it means that Evie is forced to play back. He's forced to show that respect, and that gives EDG another tower, but now they're looking for a fight.
Want to go in here. There's the ultimate coming out from the Irelia. Heimerdinger will be pulled to safety by the Lantern there. Utapon looking to get himself away, but iBoy's coming in with the Killer Instinct. Clearlove looking to engage. Can't quite find the cast just yet. Has to go into the stasis. Ray's going to be tanking up the turret the entirety of the time. Still taken very low as EDG goes dominating for their top laner, grabbing the kill onto that enemy support. That's one more off of this one. Not content just grabbing the one kill. They need even more. Stepping up, looking to put some damage onto the turret as they're trying to get the kill onto Evie, and they've already got it. Steel going to be in danger of dropping here next. The double kill goes over to Scout, who's now behind enemy lines, but totally comfortable hanging out as Utapon drops to Clearlove. I would look to see him improve on for the next game if he plays the champion again, but now the hooks are coming in. Mako's not a man who's going to be missing too much this game as they go in even further. iBoy's trying to find the damage. A Killer Instinct rings true to the name, and they pick up the kill.
Ray is going to deny that opportunity away from him.
Yeah, Ray won't let him anywhere even remotely close to the Baron Pit, and now that the objective is secure, Evie's coming in and trying to fight Ray, but this isn't really a fight you can do anything with. Evie's going to be forced to flash out of that one as Mako will continue to chase. CC is available. Ray going further.
Stand.
EDG still has two more tier 2 turrets to take down, and they're sieging up both of those right now. Middle one falls immediately as Scout is supplying the pressure on the top lane, and that one will fall here now as well. iBoy and Mako continuing to apply the pressure in the mid lane as Scout also continues the split push. Detonation Focus Me not able to find the opportunity to pull the trigger onto either one of these split push situations. Scout now going to be the one who's engaged on, goes into the stasis. Clear Love looking to disengage things with the cask. iBoy's into the back line. It's a killing spree already for Scout as EDG is running everyone down. Ray goes godlike. This should be the ace. Detonation Focus Me is completely wiped out, and EDG will march it down and find their win.
A clean 5-0 for EDG in the base of Detonation Focus Me. 20-2, and EDG are looking to secure game one.
27 minutes and 45 seconds, I said, was the average game time, Betius, and EDG has been well above average this game in every metric. They find the Nexus. 20-2.